All right, and our mission continues as we continue to fight our way through waves and waves of Sith on board the Starforge. Bastila is nearby. I can sense her in the Force. I feel a confrontation on the way. Malak is also here. We need to end this now. We need to deal with both of them one way or another and destroy this weapon before the Sith can continue to use it against the Republic. Everything has led up to this moment. Let's go, team. Alright, we've got some more Sith in here. Ooh. I don't like the look of that. Stuck in place, let's see. Jolie has... I say he's got abilities that can get us out of there or be used at a range. Alright. There we go. Let's try it one more time, maybe. Crying out loud, buddy. How do you like it? Yes, force teleportation. A powerful technique. At this rate, by the time we reach Malak, destroying the Starforge won't really matter. There's not going to be any Sith left. Just going to kill them all along the way. Alright. Ooh, come on, Bindo. There we go. Get some of that force lightning going. Revan, heal everybody as much as you can.
For the order.
Oh, they're sneaking up on us from behind. These guys just do not know when to give up. That force wave is very good. It's very helpful right now, although I kind of wish we would have taken a more damage-heavy AoE ability like the lightning or something, but I guess it wouldn't have been that much better unless we went dark side to really empower it. It would have had a pretty weak attack. Oh my goodness. We might be in a bit of a rough spot here. But I guess Jolie's not gonna go down. Jolie's already down. Juhani's not about to go down. She can hold out a few minutes longer. We'll be fine. But all of our force has been drained. Oh man, that was a rough fight. We're not even to the boss yet.
Yes.
Alright, Jolie, go ahead and use a life support pack on yourself. And throw a few more heals up. Arin, or Revan, or whatever your name is now. And we'll just let his force regenerate naturally. He's got a lot of wisdom. Shouldn't take long. Alright, there's another one. See if we can just use our lightsaber on this guy. Keep that force recharging. Oh. For a second I thought we were lucky. I thought maybe no one's gonna sneak up on us this time. Ooh, I don't like that one bit. Alright. Jolie, you have a ranged attack, so I suggest you use it. Jeez, when did they decide to start using grenades? Maybe we should follow suit. Things are looking a little bleak here. There we go, that's... oh, perfect. Nice one, Jolie. Perfect timing on that stasis field. Okay, Jolie's down. Oh my goodness, how many guys are they gonna send at us? At least we don't have any more Jedi to worry about at the moment, just a bunch of Sith troopers. I don't know if that guy behind us is still alive. Maybe we deflected a blaster bolt back into his face. Nope, he's still kicking. Alright. Take a minute to loot some of these bodies here while our people revive.
Yes.
Ichi, you use a life support pack.
Yes.
We're getting a few new ones, mostly grenades though, I think. Oh no, maybe not. Alright, there we go. Gotta keep moving. Gotta keep moving forward before more guys show up out of nowhere. Like right now. Oh, okay, they're trying to seal the way with the force or something. Again, really wish I could actually use that to push them off the side here. Would be a lot of fun. Steel or whatever it is. Alright. Come on, team. We must be getting close.
Revan, I knew you'd come for me.
I'll never give up on you, Bastila. I know you can still be saved.
You're wasting your time. I've seen the Jedi for what they are, weak and afraid. The Sith are the true masters of the Force. You've forgotten that lesson, Revan. Now you must pay the price. Here on the Starforge, the power of the dark side is at its strongest. This time, you will not defeat me.
All right, here we go.
I see now why Malak followed you. Even though you're only a shell of your former self, you're still a formidable opponent. I can't even imagine the power you must have wielded when you were the Dark Lord. You were a fool to give it all up and follow the light side.
You've been consumed by the dark side, Bastila. Can't you see it's destroying you?
The dark side has made me stronger than I ever was before. I have a greater command of the Force than all but the most powerful Jedi Masters. As Malak teaches me the greatest secrets of the Sith, I will unlock more of my potential. Eventually, there'll be no limit to what I can accomplish with the Force.
Malak will never let you become that powerful. He'll kill you first.
Have you forgotten the ways of the Sith already, Revan? Eventually, I will challenge my master. If I am worthy, he will die by my hand, and I will become the new Sith Master. Then I will take on my own apprentice, and the cycle will begin again. This is the way of the Sith. It is how we assure our leaders are always the strongest and most worthy.
You're dooming yourselves to an endless cycle of death and betrayal.
No, Revan. It is you who are doomed. You're growing weary. I can sense it. Your strength falters. The light side is failing you while the power of the Starforge re-energizes me. Soon this will all be over.
I have not faltered, Bastila. You've been misled by the dark side.
The dark side will always triumph over the light. Malak has assured me of victory. You can't defeat me here on the Starforge. You can't! So, this is not possible. You have rejected the dark side. You are a weak and pathetic servant of the light. How can you still stand against me? Why can't I defeat you?
Now you see the dark side is not stronger than the light.
Yes, I see you speak the truth. I am no match for you. Please, for the sake of what we once shared, do not make me suffer. End my life quickly. There is no other way.
I could never kill you, Bastila.
What other choice do you have? I have fallen to the dark side. I am the apprentice to the Dark Lord himself. You cannot let me live.
I was redeemed, Bastila. You can be too.
You were a special case. The Council had no other choice. They needed you alive so they could discover the location of the Starforge. It was an act of desperation. It was my responsibility to watch over you, to make sure you did not slip back into your evil ways. I was supposed to protect you from the dark side.
You did more than protect me, Bastila.
It's true I possess feelings for you. But was it only an illusion brought about by our bond? And what was the cost? Please, this is too painful. End it now, quickly. There is no other way.
I love you, Bastila. I could never abandon you. Ever.
You love me. There was a time I yearned for, and yet dreaded to hear those words. I loved you too, but I could never face who you were. Malak knew how I felt. Any part of the light that was within me would be extinguished when I killed you. But what good is love? It cannot save me from the sea of blackness I am drowning in. I have betrayed everything I ever believed in. How can I atone for that?
Help us defeat the Sith, Bastila. This will atone for what you've done.
Yes, I could join you in your battle against the Dark Lord. That alone would not make up for all I have done. Yet it would be a step in the right direction. But how would you be able to trust me? How do you know I wouldn't turn on you when you faced Darth Malak? How do you know the dark side wouldn't make me betray you again?
I trust you enough to leave myself open to that attack, Bastila.
You play a dangerous game. Are you certain you wish to take this risk? I could end your life and gain Malak's favor with a single stroke of my lightsaber.
But you won't, Bastila. I love you, and I believe in you.
You are brave, and some would say foolish. But you were also right. The dark side has not wholly consumed me. I cannot raise my blade against you. You will go on to defeat Malak. Of this I have little doubt. You will have gone from being the Sith Lord himself to the savior of our galaxy. And you said you loved me. This may not be the best time to say it, but I love you too, with all my heart.
You aren't afraid to love anymore?
After this? No. Nothing could make me feel safer than to be loved by you. You should go. Malak awaits. This isn't over yet. For any of us. I should stay here, though. If we face Malak, I am afraid his dark presence will overwhelm me. It would not be wise to expose myself to such temptation.
Bastila, I want you at my side when I face the Dark Lord.
I'm sorry, but the risk is too great. I'm not wholly free of the dark side shadow. Not yet. But that you are more than a match for the Dark Lord. I understand that now. I will stay here in this chamber and use my battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet. I am their only hope of destroying the Star Forge and ending the Sith menace. You must go and face Malak, but you have to hurry. Once I turn the battle in the Republic's favor, we won't have much time to escape the Star Forge before it's destroyed. Good luck, my love, and may the Force be with you.
There, a break in the Sith formations. Green Squadron, move in.
Green Squadron, moving in. Green Squadron's through. We've broken their lines. Astala is no longer using her battle meditation against us. The tide has turned.
Red Squadron, into the breach. Capital ships, reinforce their position.
All right, this is it. All that's left now is to face Malak himself. It's time to end this, once and for all. Heal ourselves up here before we venture much further. Why is that not? There we go. All right.
The mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble grasp. You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Star Forge fuels my command of the dark side. You are no match for me here, and this time you will not escape.
It's you who can't escape, Malak. Surrender now and the Jedi might show you mercy.
Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die.
I was saved from the darkness, Malak. You can be too, if you wish.
Spoken like a true slave of the Jedi Code. Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master, I will let the Star Forge itself destroy you.
We've got droids. Not to worry. Oh, God. group up. Oh. Okay. Looks like they're just gonna keep making more. Maybe we can hack these here. Computer spikes. I don't know if I can hack them on in combat is the problem. Alright, let's take a look here. Override system to generate a droid to help me. 12 spikes. How many do we have? 62. Might as well. All right. The amount of force we're using to actually fight these things, we could literally do this all day. Alright, come on. Make another beneficial droid. There we go, right into the fray. Number 3 coming up. Oh, nice. The friendlies have flamethrowers. That's pretty cool. It'd be really cool if they looked like HK. That'd just be awesome. Alright, come on. Scales are turning now. There are now more friendly droids being made than hostile ones. We don't have enough. Sable. Maybe one of these has some spikes in it we could use. Perfect. Alright. Come, my army. Let's face the Lord of the Sith. Up an energy shield on myself. I have a feeling this is going to be a difficult fight.
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. but I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
The light side is stronger than you know, Malak.
I am tempted to try and capture you alive, Revan. Then I could break your will and bind you to me as my apprentice, as I did Bastila. You would be a far greater asset to me than even Bastila and her battle meditation, if I could control you. But is it worth the risk? Perhaps you are too powerful to be my apprentice. I betrayed you when I realized my own strength was greater than yours. In time, you might try to do the same to me.
This is your last chance, Malak. Surrender.
No, Revan. This time our confrontation can only end in death. Yours or mine. Once again, we shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
All right. Here we go. Oh, come on, Revan. Come on, life support pack. Another one. There we go.
You continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
What are you talking about?
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers, and it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead, except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me. You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. Your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
Well, that doesn't sound pleasant. Alright, let's throw a shield up on ourselves. Another life support pack. See, maybe we can... If you're not using the shield and the life support pack, Revan. Alright, these attacks are proving pretty ineffective. Alright, where's he going? Let him go do that. We need to... Alright, he's going to keep... drawing power from these pods unless we destroy them. These Jedi are already dead already. You're simply releasing them so they can become one with the Force. I think that was all of them. Alright, you. Let's end this. Maybe a critical strike might be a little more effective. It actually works fairly well.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
It is the way of the dark side, Malak. All things end in death.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I return to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would I have found?
I'm sorry I started you on this path, but it was you who chose to continue down it.
I suppose you speak the truth. I alone must accept responsibility for my fate. I wanted to be master of the Sith and ruler of the galaxy, but that destiny was not mine, Revan. It might have been yours, perhaps, but never mine. And in the end, as the darkness takes me, I am nothing.
There you are. What happened?
Darth Malak is dead. It's over. Finally.
That's wonderful news. There's no time to celebrate just yet. I was able to use my battle meditation to allow the Republic to break through the Sith fleet. The capital ships are in bombardment range.
And that means we all have to get out of here right now before this entire complex comes down around our ears. Everyone else is already on the ship. Let's move.
Dodona. We've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down.
We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed, and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
You have defeated Malak, destroyed the Starforge, and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory, the highest honor the Republic can bestow. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the Saviors of the Republic.
On behalf of the Jedi Council, defenders of the galaxy, and sworn protectors of the Republic, I, too, would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave into the grand history of our Eternal Order. The redemption of Revan, the prodigal knight. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day, you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side. For this is the destiny of the Jedi.